How do dependencies fit into our model of debugging? Well, that's fairly straightforward. When we see a failure, we see which part of the state is erroneous, and then we track back the dependencies to see which earlier states could possibly have caused that infection. And we determine these possible states, as well as the locations in the program where they would be caused, through the dependencies. So if we see an error down here, it could have come from here, or from here. And one out of these three, or at least one out of these three, should contain the infection that we're looking for. So we use dependencies to find possible origins for each infection. In the second step, we use the scientific method to track down infections. We have the choice between three possible origins here. So we use the scientific method to find out which of these three parts of the state is at fault. We set up an experiment, we make up the appropriate observation, and we gradually refine or reject our hypothesis until we have come up with a diagnosis and figured out which part of the state is wrong. Then we repeat the whole thing back and back and back again, again choosing between multiple possible origins, following back the dependencies, and again using the scientific method to track down which of these actually is at fault. Instead of the scientific method, you can also use deduction to rule out specific possibilities. For instance, you may be able to show that neither this one nor this one can possibly have influenced the state under these circumstances. So the only one that remains is the one up here. You repeat the process until you find a statement whose ingoing state is all correct, but where the outgoing state is infected. So, how do we call a statement whose ingoing state is all correct, but its outgoing state is infected? What is this? Is this a cause, a defect, or an infection?